In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, the grace and peace of our risen Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
My sisters and brothers, we gather on this second Sunday of Easter, designated as Divine Mercy Sunday. Today, the church throughout the world is invited to open their hearts to the loving divine mercy of our Lord. I pray now that that gift of peace and healing may enter your hearts and your homes as we prepare now to celebrate these wondrous and sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you raise the dead to life in the Spirit. Lord, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring pardon and peace to the sinner. Christ, have mercy. Lord Jesus, you bring light to those in darkness. Lord, have mercy. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us all to everlasting life.
Amen.
Glory to God in the highest. Glory to God in the highest. And on earth peace to people of goodwill. Glory to God in the highest.
Let us pray. God of everlasting mercy, who in the very recurrence of the Paschal feast kindle the faith of the people you have made your own, increase, we pray, the grace you have bestowed, that all may grasp and rightly understand in what font they have been washed, by whose spirit they have been reborn, by whose blood they have been redeemed. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. They devoted themselves to the teaching of the apostles and to the communal life, to the breaking of bread and to the prayers. Awe came upon everyone, and many wonders and signs were done through the apostles. All who believed were together and had all things in common. They would sell their property and possessions and divide them among all according to each one's need. Every day they devoted themselves to meeting together in the temple area and to the breaking bread in their homes. They ate their meals with exultation and sincerity of heart, praising God and enjoying favor with all the people. And every day the Lord added to their number those who were being saved. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, his love is ever.
A reading from the first letter of St. Peter. Blessed be the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who in his great mercy gave us a new birth to a living hope through the resurrection of Jesus Christ from the dead, to an inheritance that is imperishable, undefiled, and unfading, kept in heaven for you who by the power of God are safeguarded through faith to a salvation that is ready to be revealed in the final time. In this you rejoice, although now, for a little while, you may have to suffer through various trials, so that the genuineness of your faith, more precious than gold that is perishable even though tested by fire, may prove to be for praise, glory, and honor at the revelation of Jesus Christ. Although you have not seen him, you love him. Even though you do not see him now, yet believe in him, you rejoice with the indescribable and glorious joy as you attain the goal of your faith, the salvation of your souls. The word of the Lord.
My sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
On the evening of that first day of the week, when the doors were locked where the disciples were, for fear of the Jews, Jesus came and stood in their midst and said to them, "Peace be with you." When he had said this, he showed them his hands and his side. The disciples rejoiced when they saw the Lord. Jesus said to them again, "Peace be with you. As the Father has sent me, so I send you." And when he had said this, he breathed on them and said to them, "Receive the Holy Spirit. Whose sins you forgive are forgiven them, and whose sins you retain are retained." Thomas, called Didymus, one of the 12, was not with them when Jesus came. So the other disciples said to him, "We have seen the Lord." But he said to them, "Unless I see the mark of the nails in his hands, and put my finger into the nail marks, and put my hand into his side, I will not believe." Now a week later, his disciples were again inside, and Thomas was with them. Jesus came, although the doors were locked, and stood in their midst and said, "Peace be with you." Then he said to Thomas, "Put your finger here and see my hands, and bring your hand and put it into my side, and do not be unbelieving, but believe." Thomas answered and said to him, "My Lord and my God." Jesus said to him, "Have you come to believe because you have seen me? Blessed are those who have not seen and have believed." Now Jesus did many other signs in the presence of his disciples that are not written in this book, but these are written that you may come to believe that Jesus is the Christ, the Son of God, and that through this belief you may have life in his name. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
You could not ask for a better example of divine mercy than the gospel that we just heard proclaimed. In today's gospel, the disciples have quarantined themselves in the upper room since the moment that Jesus died on the cross. They are afraid that the authorities will do to them what they did to Jesus. So they remain behind bolted doors, focusing on their fears. However, locked doors cannot keep the risen Jesus out. And the first words out of Jesus' mouth were not words of condemning Peter for denying him or for the others for running away and leaving him at the moment of the crucifixion all by himself or for not believing when he said he would rise from the dead. But rather, his first words to them were, "Peace be with you." And then he said it again, "Peace be with you." And then a week later, he returned because Thomas wasn't there, and he repeats the same words, "Peace be with you." He breaks through and offers them the spirit of forgiveness. He shows them how great is his mercy that even bolted doors can't keep him out. And with that, he brings to their hearts that had only known fear. He brought to them the true gift of his peace and mercy. I love St. Thomas. You could consider him the spiritual father of anyone who ever questioned, anyone who ever wondered or doubted. He's so real. He speaks for anyone who has ever wrestled with their faith. Anyone who has ever been challenged to believe the unbelievable or find the incredible credible. In a sense, Thomas speaks for all of us at one time or another in our lives. He speaks for us when our prayer life is weak, when doubt is strong, when fear and anxiety and mistrust overwhelm us. Anyone who has ever struggled with their faith or felt distant from God can find a kindred spirit in St. Thomas, which is why this gospel is so critical and so relevant, especially today, Divine Mercy Sunday, and especially with all that we are going through right now in these very uncertain and difficult times of the coronavirus pandemic. And it isn't just that Thomas came to believe, that he was moved to exclaim, "My Lord and my God," but it's how it happened. In John's account, Jesus first appeared to the apostles while Thomas wasn't there. And then as Thomas, as we heard, was incredulous when the disciples told him that he had risen, that they had seen him. He didn't buy it. It sounded too good to be true. And he basically said, "Show me." So Jesus appears a second time, and this time Thomas was there, and he saw and believed. And it all happened for one reason, because Jesus gave him another chance. He offered him another opportunity, a way back from doubt to faith, from skepticism to belief. He knew what Thomas needed. He knew what Thomas was lacking, So Jesus, the very font of divine mercy, returned to the upper room a second time in a gesture of mercy and left one man profoundly changed. A skeptic became a saint. It happened for Thomas. It can also happen for us. This is what lies at the heart of this particular Sunday, and it lies at the heart of the sacrament of reconciliation, the opportunity given to us to begin again anew, to start over, and to receive the loving, forgiving mercy of our God. Jesus didn't give up on Thomas, and Jesus will never give up on us. Jesus comes to each one of us today, and particularly today into your own home or wherever you are right now. And he comes before you today, and he says those same words that he said to the apostles in the upper room, "Peace be with you. Don't be afraid. I am with you now and always." My sisters and brothers, on this first Sunday of Easter, or second Sunday of Easter, as we celebrate Divine Mercy Sunday, it is up to us, like Thomas, to simply open our hearts, our minds, our very souls to the mercy that God wants to pour out upon us through his risen Son, Jesus Christ. Today, as I mentioned a number of times now, it's Divine Mercy Sunday. And this beautiful feast is in response to a request that Jesus himself made when he appeared to Sister Faustina, a young nun to whom he appeared to in 1931 in her convent cell near Krakow in Poland. He desired that on this day we reflect on his infinite mercy and run to him in our weakness and in our need. In her well-published diary, now Saint Faustina recorded these words which Jesus spoke to her. He said, "My daughter, tell the whole world about my inconceivable mercy. I desire that the Feast of Mercy be a refuge and shelter for all souls, and especially poor sinners. On that day, the very depths of my tender mercy are open. I pour out a whole ocean of graces upon those souls who approach the font of my mercy. The soul that will go to confession and receive Holy Communion shall obtain complete forgiveness of sin and punishment. Let no soul fear to draw near to me. Humanity will not find peace until it returns to the font of my mercy." My sisters and brothers, it was our late Holy Father, now Pope St. John Paul II, who canonized Sister Faustina 20 years ago on the second Sunday after Easter in the year 2000. And on that day, he called the Church Universal to celebrate this Sunday as Divine Mercy Sunday in order to spread the message of Jesus' divine mercy throughout the world. Pope John Paul II died 5 years later on the eve of Divine Mercy Sunday. Today, Jesus is inviting all of us to accept his forgiveness and the healing that he wants to bestow on us when we approach him with a trusting heart. He wants to dispel our fears, and he wants to fill us with great peace. Back in 1931, when our Lord appeared to Saint Faustina in another vision, she saw Jesus clothed in a white garment, with his right hand in blessing, and his left hand was touching his garment at the very area of his heart. And from there, two large rays came forth, one red, the other pale, representing the blood and the water flowing from his side. Jesus said to her, "Paint an image according to the pattern you see, with the signature, Jesus, I trust in you. I promise that the soul that will venerate this image will not perish. I also promise victory over its enemies already here on earth, especially at the hour of death. I myself will defend it as my own glory. I am offering people a vessel with which they are to keep coming for graces to the fountain of mercy. That vessel is this image with the signature, Jesus, I trust in you. I desire that this image be venerated first in your chapel and then throughout the world. This image of divine mercy before us today is every day at our side altar here in the Basilica at the Chapel of the Sacred Heart. Every morning I stop and pray before the Lord those simple but profound words, Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Especially on those days when I'm feeling overly anxious, when I'm afraid or doubt or fear, I'm reminded of those powerful words. And today, my sisters and brothers, I encourage you to pray this beautiful, simple prayer, especially in your own moments of doubt, your own moments of fear and weakness. Jesus, I trust in you. Jesus, I trust in you. Amen. Together now, let us profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary and became man. For our sake he was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified, who has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and apostolic church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. My sisters and brothers, let us now humbly bring our prayers before our merciful and loving God.
The response will be, Lord, hear our prayer. For the church, that as the body of the risen Christ here on earth, God's Holy Spirit may guide us in proclaiming the truth and the hope of the resurrection. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For peace and justice in the world, may Easter grace be with all nations and peoples in turning away from division. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who struggle each day to make ends meet, may God grant them a spirit of fortitude, and for the sick and the dying, may they be comforted. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For scientists, healthcare professionals, public officials, and all who are serving the common good in this difficult and uncertain time, that they will be filled with wisdom and understanding. And for the end of the coronavirus pandemic, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all who have died, may they share with the saints the reward of eternal joy. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of our living and deceased parishioners and benefactors for whom this Eucharist is being offered, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Almighty and eternal God, as we celebrate this Divine Mercy Sunday, we ask you to hear the prayers that we have spoken out loud and the prayers that we hold in the silence of our hearts. Through Christ, our risen Lord, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
Pray now, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be pleasing and acceptable to God, our Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice in your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of our holy church.
Accept, O Lord, we pray, the oblations of your people, that renewed by confession of your name and by baptism, they may attain unending happiness through Christ our Lord. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We have lifted up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but on this day above all, to laud you yet more gloriously when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he destroyed our death. By rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and the working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, Lord, we humbly implore you by that same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
Eat this bread and drink this cup. We proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again, until you come again.
Therefore, Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant, Francis our Pope, the order of bishops, all the clergy, the religious, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned here before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who were pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil, and graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. My friends, the peace of the risen Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
And may that peace now enter your hearts, enter your homes, wherever you are at this moment. We share that peace with one another. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that our reception of this Paschal sacrament may have a continuing effect in our minds and our hearts through Christ our Lord. And our prayer now for Father Baker's canonization. Lord, you gave us your servant, Nelson Baker, as an example of service to the poor, homeless, and young. By Father Baker's ardent concern for those in need, inflame our hearts and lives with compassion for the poor, justice for the oppressed, hope for the troubled, and courage to those in doubt.
We pray through the intercession of Our Lady of Victory, if it be your will, that your servant, Nelson Baker, may one day be canonized. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Our Lady of Victory, pray for us. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Please bow your heads now and pray for God's blessing. May God, who by the resurrection of his only begotten Son, was pleased to confer on you the gift of redemption and of adoption, give you gladness by his blessing. Amen. May he, by whose redeeming work you have received the gift of everlasting freedom, make you heirs to an eternal inheritance. Amen. And may you, who have already risen with Christ in baptism through faith, by living in a right manner on this earth, be united with him in the homeland of heaven. Amen. And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in the peace of Christ. Alleluia.
Alleluia.